sell these flowers at the Pike Place Market. You don't know that young people are a very, very important part of the Pike Place Market. You may not know that we even have a school program in the Seattle Public Schools for second, third, and fourth graders. We put them through a rigorous two-week in-school training program where they learn all about some of the alternative methods of selling in the Pike Place Market. And then we bring them down here for a special day in the market where they meet merchants, where they learn about new opportunities possibly for themselves, and they learn about the true aspects of diversity and community. Well, we have some more kids that are going to be here today to help celebrate the market. After the ceremony at noon, we have a group of kids that are organized by one of our local residents. And they call themselves the Global Kids. And they do a lot of hand drumming. And they do ethnic percussion numbers from around the world. And they're going to join us right after the ceremony. So you're going to hear some good music from some more kids. Stick around for that. The Global Kids immediately after the ceremony. And some hand percussion. Also, if you just joined us, these flowers you see up here at the market information table and by the podium we have set up. We're part of a bouquet contest that we challenged our market farmers with this morning. And we awarded some prizes for the people who could put together the best bouquets. We had some distinguished judges help us choose. Well, these bouquets are going to be auctioned off today, probably around 1 o'clock, because we're running low. Oh, and they just keep on coming. So there's going to be more opportunity for people to carry home some of these beautiful flowers today. Yes, please, do they? About 1 o'clock or 1:15. Actually, we're running a little late because the governor's got a flat or something, but he's on his way. But we're going to have our auction a little later than we planned. So about 1:15 today, we're going to ask you to stick around, bid for these bouquets, and the proceeds of which are going to go to the Market Senior Center to help with some of their programs. All of these flowers are grown, picked, and sold by market farmers here in the Pike Place Market. So this is a very, very special chance to get a piece of the market to take home with you on this special day. The market's a special place. You never know who you're going to see here. Turn around. You may be looking at a movie star. You may be looking at a sports star. You may be looking at someone who's just as important as you are.
See if we can find them.
Hey. some of the farmers and some of the merchants that have made that challenge so much easier and have made our lives so much more pleasant in accomplishing our vision. I would like now to invite Shelly Yap, our executive director, and Millie Padua up to present some awards to our long-standing farmers. Millie herself was once a market farmer and for the past 21 years has been our market master.
Shelly.
Thank you, John. As those of you who've been here before know, this is my favorite day of the year when we celebrate market anniversary, and we have lots of anniversaries that we are celebrating today. Our 89th year, the 25th year of keeping the market in Seattle, and can you imagine Seattle without our wonderful market? And 10 years for Rachel. It's Rachel's birthday today as well. One of the things that this day always has us do is remember our beginnings. And our beginnings were the farmers on the street selling directly to the consumer and bypassing the wholesaler and broker that was gouging people on prices. So our core, our roots are in the ground and with the farmers. And today we want to recognize farmers who are celebrating 15 years of being a farmer in the market, and then we have one extraordinarily special presentation on farmers to make, which we'll do at the very
delicate.
End. Millie is going to help me. This is the 15-year gold pin that we give to farmers who've been with
gentlemen
us for
and
that
scholars,
long.
Sir.
Not all
just
of them
clear.
Can be here today, but I will go first to the ones that
we don't want anybody to say that some of the lanes were slower when we win some of the tournaments later.
Our math isn't always right.
Someone else would be
So if we got it wrong, and I know we got Sabrina's wrong, you can tell me when we come up, and we'll still give you a 15-year pin. So please come up as I call your name, and Millie will give you your deal. Erica and Clarita Santos, farmers from Kent, fresh and dried flowers. Eric, Clarita? All right, well, they are right around the corner over there, so they should be back over here. By the way, these farmers have a green ribbon on their tables today, celebrating their 15th anniversary, right above the light bar. So when you get done here, you can go by and make a 15th anniversary purchase from them. Doris Meck from Maple Valley, honey and bee products. And I think Doris might be another one who tells me I've got the wrong number of years. Sabrina and Werner Dreyer from Snohomish, fresh and potted flowers. And Sabrina made this gorgeous, later to be auctioned for the benefit of the Senior Center, this gorgeous first place winning bouquet here. You remember, 19 years is the correct number for her. Linda Boicano from Tacoma, beans, peppers, garlic, fresh and dried flowers. Linda's been with us for 15 years. Lucito Charisma from Kent, fresh and dried flowers. Lucito, did he get out here?
Here
he goes. Did she make it in? Okay. The Israel family, Forgiven and Rejoice. I know they're here. They were the second prize winners with this wonderful herb bouquet. Okay, now let me go through the other farmers who are celebrating 15 years who are not here today. Dave Altberg from Ellensburg, cherries. Nolan Booty from Allen, beans, lettuce, grapes, and fresh flowers. Tim Johannes from Puyallup with berries. Steve Benzel from Waldron with garlic. And I think that does it for the 15-year farmers. Let's get them all a hand, if you would. Now it is my great honor to ask Lucille and Casey Cruz to come up and join us. And Casey are related over here to Millie. If you can see the resemblance, these are sisters here. We have a couple more years before we celebrate this with Millie, but with Casey and Lucille, today we are celebrating 50 years as market farmers.
patrons, residents, and customers of the market we have always enjoyed sincere friendship and generous support from beers in both the private and public sectors. Today, we are privileged to have with us one of the market's staunchest friends and allies.
Market Preservation Development Authority and all the board members for all you do. Now we have at least two major citizen boards that are so key in continuing this. And of course the Preservation Development Authority, all that time is very, very important. Also the Historic Board is also very important. I appreciate being recognized as one of those political leaders. We all know that the real key that developed the Pike Place Market and kept the Pike Place Market was the citizens. 89 years ago, people said, we're going to develop this. And 25 years ago, when the market was going to be lost, it was the citizens, the friends of the market, Peter Steinbrück and others, who all came together with the addition to say, no, we're going to save the market. And it's the citizens that keep that going now. And we will forever have a Pike Place Market public authority here for all the people. And so as governor of the state of Washington, I want to thank the farmers and everyone that continues to make this such a wonderful quality of life item in our state. You know, I go on these junkets all over the world, and all over the world I have people tell me that, like, Paul, I know you have people tell you and others do that they have been to the Pike Place Market and they ask me about it. And this is a tremendous attraction for people from all over the world to come here to Seattle. It's also a major factor for other farmers market success around the state. We've had a real growth in farmers market in the last few years, and this market is major in helping others of those happen. And so I just want to thank all the authority board members, John, Shelley Yap, for doing such a great job, and all of you for keeping Seattle and the state of Washington the greatest place in the whole world. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Paul. are two of the original members of the DDA Council. It is hard to imagine the sense of excitement and challenge that that original council faced. I'd like you all to, I'd like to invite up Jack Baghdad and Gene Falls. If you'd please step forward. Jack has on a very special button on his lapel also. And finally, we have with us today Yale Lewis. Yale was the original council of the market. He helped direct many of our founding documents, or craft our founding documents, and do much of the work that allowed for the difficult financing and development of this market. For 10 years, our legal counsel, Yale. Unfortunately, it is not possible to acknowledge all who have worked and sacrificed to make the Pike Place Market the living landmark that it is today. Many have gone, but gratefully some remain, and some of those who joined the fight to save the market 25 years ago still serve today. In this regard, there is one familiar face in the market that we are very pleased to honor today. She gave entirely to keep the market initiative campaign, serving as the secretary of Friends of the Market Citizens Group. She has since given thousands of hours of her time as a volunteer to support human service work in the Market Foundation, where she continues to devote her considerable energy to this very hour. Elizabeth, I want to thank you for taking a few moments off. Please join me in acknowledging and honoring Elizabeth.
Debbie and Joe Hopgood. for 26 years in 1970. Hi, Debbie. Also, starting in 1970, the Kay family, with silly old mayor, I think it used to be Space 31. Tracy? Where's Tracy? I saw Tracy here. Okay, old friends. It used to be what? Jungle plants or something like that? Rick was one of the first people to tell me about what it was like to move into the sanitary market during renovation. We had a great time. And soon as Mom's not around, but thank you, Rick. 28 years with him. 1967, Lynn or Morning here. I think I saw Lynn, Great Western Trading Company. Okay, Lynn said she wouldn't make it, but we got her daughter to force it. Okay, got her. Hold up, thank you. Great Western Trading Company. Hazel, I know, made it today. Hazel called up, said I was sick, but I'll show up. Hazel from Ruse and Ruse, 29 years since 1967. There you are. Okay, the next group, 31 to 40 years, and the list keeps going. Johnny Yokoyama gave up his golf game on, made it down here. 31 years he's at it. What story you traded? Did you have any more or what?
Riviera.
Buick Riviera bought that store. Johnny's family's been here a lot longer. His dad had produce stand, Roy's Produce. 31 years also. John Farias. He keeps changing his business and moving it around. He started with Liberty Malt Supply in 1965. It became Pike Place Brewery. The brewery moved on beyond him, and he's opening up Market Cellar Winery now down on Western. Hi, John. Thank you. Swanberg. Brian here from the Swanberg family. Anyone? John? John Blocker? I don't see anybody here, but Swanberg's gifts from 1965. Main Arcade, you can come out and get it. The Art Stall Collective, one of the centerpieces all the way through the initiative campaign. 31 years since 1965. Barbara Nicholson. Great, thank you. Copa Cabana. I heard Martha was here. Martha's dad started the Copa Cabana. It was like Alex's. What was it? Five seeds? Shrimp, chicken, fish, and beef. Thank you. Martha Valley. Larry Howard. I was surprised to find out that Larry has been here as long as 32 years since 1964. Larry? Or is he cutting hair? He said the ceremony's going along, he might be back in the shop, but he's in the corner market. Lena, Constantino, Lena. Lena, I can't believe, oh, you took a time off. How did you do that? Lena.
She'll charge
Lena
you for
it, more beautiful every year than 33 years since 1963. Okay, Frank, Tommy is not off the Philippines yet. Frank. Maybe he is. Okay, Frank Banabi from Philippine Imports, also since 63. Pike Place Bar and Grill, Gordy and Sandy. They get so many awards, they're right up there. They may still be up there right now. So we'll see how this is working. Gordy and Sandy may come in a little bit later here. Bavarian Meats, did Jerry show 47 Greenbank family over in Pointer Market, still there. They were in the sanitary market out in the middle for a long time. Thank you very much. 1947, give us a deal. And now we're going all the way up, 50 years or more. And I guess I should do this in the right order. Who do you have, Ed? Okay, Lou. Lou DeLoretti. Come on over. You can make it in. We were going to, this is the golden anniversary for DeLoretti.
Looking for a merchant for this award, we
offers here in the market. Tony? This year we started doing a little best of the market. Entries into that, and our time here is very limited today, so we're just going to highlight a few of the kind of amusing ones. And if you look in the next issue of the market news, you will find a listing of what the shoppers and residents and people who make the market what it is think the best is. The first guest of the market goes to the most bodacious market personality, which is David Larson, who works on our custodial staff. And David receives this award for asking Thomas, I don't know if Thomas wants to be identified, but I am, if his date was his mom. The date was subsequently ended rather quickly. However, Thomas was not too upset because he said the date wasn't going real well anyway, so David kind of ended up doing a service for him. So we're going to award David a course on how to win friends and influence people. All right. The next is the best kept secret in the market, and we're not going to say who this secret belongs to, but if she wants to come up and acknowledge it, that's her choice. This is the market personality who went to a formal dinner without any shoes on. She forgot to pack them in her suitcase when she was leaving for her trip, and she went out shopping, and she said, I don't want to pay this much money for a pair of shoes I already got at home. So she ended up going sans shoes. So we have a little award if she wants to, or a little gift for her if she wants to come up and grab her shoes. Always has a smile on his face. He is a has just gone gangbusters in the last 2 years, bringing that garage on line to milk it the fullest. He has got a couple of our merchants unhappy at him because he, and even his staff, when he took the early bird off on Saturdays and then upped the early bird rate, but he kept reminding them he was doing it so that there would be parking for their customers. Gil, I can't thank you enough for your service to the PDA and to the market, and it's a pleasure to honor you. Thank you very much.
All right.
Andrew is going to auction off our flowers now.